Yeah, Assemblyman Ron Danser, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Good morning. My pleasure, Bill.
All right. So, Ron, let me ask you, I was listening to how Eric explained this, and yes, there absolutely is some ambiguity in how the attorney general has explained this. But what my understanding of the idea behind a sanctuary city, and go back to Rudy Giuliani in New York, and that was that they did not want people to not go to the hospital or not report a criminal tip if they had, you know, if they had knowledge of some crime. My understanding of your bill is that will not hurt anybody in that sense. This is only someone who is arrested for a crime. You would then take the next step to determine their legality. Is that right?
Correct, Bill. This bill targets illegal immigrant criminals. Those have been convicted of crimes, which the crimes that are in the category are really what we refer to as the Enforcement Priority Program, include crimes such as DWI, gang activities, domestic violence, sexual abuse, burglary, drug dealers, and, of course, unlawful use or possession of a firearm.
Mm-hmm. Now, how would this hold politicians accountable? So I'm going to be joined later today by Liz Lempert. She's the mayor in Princeton. And I've been agitated for a while because this whole issue of the 9/11 memorial that has not been put up yet because there's a cross carved in it. But that issue aside, the government in Princeton has talked about, even though I understand they haven't made the cut as far as what defines a sanctuary city, but they've definitely said that Princeton is one of those places where they do not want law enforcement getting involved in immigration issues. How would you hold a mayor like that accountable? What would happen?
Well, accountability in this legislation will be, number one, that any municipality in the state of New Jersey that either adopts a policy, a ordinance, or resolution pertaining to providing sanctuary mm-hmm. for illegal immigrants that are criminals, there would be, number one, ethics violations against those elected and appointed officials. And secondly, there would be a misdemeanor crime committed, which carries under this legislation a $1,000 fine and a discretion of the judge now, up to a one-year prison term.
Ron, how big is the problem in New Jersey? I mean, I know that we have one of the highest illegal immigrant populations in the country in terms of percentage of workforce. I think it's 8% of the workforce, they estimate. So how big is the criminal problem?
It's a large problem, not only numerically, but with respect to safety. First of all, there are approximately 500,000 illegal immigrants here in the state of New Jersey. Now, not all of them are criminals that are targeted under this legislation. But keep in mind, our number one priority as elected and appointed officials is to provide for the safety and the general welfare of the people that we represent. And we also raise that right hand and take an oath that we're going to uphold the laws of the state of New Jersey. And this is not being done, and it's precariously placing the general public at risk, such as the San Francisco sanctuary policy where Kate Steinle was murdered.
Kate Steinle was murdered by a man that, by all accounts, should never have been here, or he should have been rotting in a prison somewhere, probably not in America. And you're right about that, Ron. Well, good luck to you. I know with the assembly, the disastrous election for Republicans last Tuesday, it's going to be a lot harder. Hopefully a bill like this at least gets some discussion on the part of Democrats who are in the majority. But Ron, let's stay in touch on this, and good luck.